Every stitch we make, make it history, make. Pay attention, no tension on this we make. If the shattered broke, then we fixing in. If the pattern's dope, then we stitching in. Pay attention in, I'ma mention in. Call up a couple friends, say we stitching in. Hope we got the flaws, then we not too lost. If we frog place bricks, then we got the boss. Make lots of noise, cause we
talk. Hi Flosstube, welcome to Stitching It. My name is Stephanie, and I'm a cross-stitcher outside of Atlanta, Georgia, and this is my YouTube channel about my hobbies of needlework and cross-stitch. So, welcome, and it's been about a month since my last update, so I didn't mean to take so long to come back, but, you know, a lot's been going on, and I don't really want to go into it that much, but, I'm glad you're here, and I have definitely been trying to stitch my feelings away, is what I feel like I've been doing. You know, I feel like I've turned into a really emotional stitcher as the year has progressed, meaning whatever my feeling is at the time, you know, I have to have a project to go along with that feeling or that emotion. And this time, you know, I've spent more time on projects that were really, like I said, calling to my emotions more than anything. So it's going to be a little interesting talk. But before I get started on that, I just wanted to tell you the results of the giveaway that I was doing for last time. It was a $15 Amazon gift card. And yeah, and we had, let's see now, I put everybody's names in Tiny Decisions, and we had about, 12 people entering the giveaway, so that's pretty good chances, and like I said, I put it on my phone here, and I'm just going to do the spin real quick so I can show you guys who the winner is. Let's see if I can get it to focus on the phone. Not my face. This was not a good idea. Let's try it again. There we go. Okay. So I'll hit the button now. All right, Trisha. She is the winner, and I will be contacting you on the comment that you left on the last video, and we'll try to get in touch with each other so that I can deliver your gift card to you. So congratulations. Thank you everyone for watching and entering. I had announced last time that I was having difficulty with my biggest project of the year, which is His Eyes on the Sparrow, and I haven't picked that back up again yet, but I've been sort of feeding my stitchy bug here and there, you know, and it's going fine. You know, I was worried at first, especially when I started diamond painting, that it was going to like overtake stitching, or they were going to compete with each other. And they are a little bit, but I'm kind of settling into a schedule and a sort of a routine for what I've got going on. So, let's see, the first project I want to show you guys, I can't remember the last time I showed it on this channel. It's a long dog sampler, and I do tend to get it out in the fall, and this is Quilts. You know, I love long dog samplers, and they just released a new one, which I'll show you in a second, because of course I had to start it. But this has been out for, I don't remember, I think 2018 it might have been when it came out. And I'm about 20% now. So I've come around the top corner, and this is done with the DMC colors on 28 count even weave with two strands. And I've been stitching it in hand, so this is really a comfort stitch for me, because like I said, it's in 28 count and it's nice and big and roomy when I'm stitching, and since I'm doing it in hand, I can really take it with me anywhere. So that's been getting some stitches in it. I'm going to be doing a pretty quick, I think, today, just so I can go through some more projects than I normally do. Oh, okay. So speaking of long dog samplers, they just released a new sampler the other day called the House of Peacocks. And, you know, I love long dog samplers. And so I'm open to starting one whenever they come out, you know. And so this one I loved. I'll put a picture of that one up. But it is really beautiful. It's got these diagonal motifs, you know, in it with a lot of stitching. And I love the color palette. So I'll show you what I've got going. I've been in the Color and Cotton Fabric Club since April, I think, and I'm getting 40 count neutral is the specific count. I'm getting a quarter yard of 40 count neutral fabric every month, and so I'm starting to get like quite a little collection of it. So so I wanted to crack open some of that. This is like, I think it's September's, and it was called Special Edition. And yeah, it looks really good. I'm gonna get up close so I can show you, since it is on 40 count. I didn't get a chance to iron it or anything, but I started in the middle and ran all the way up to the corner. But let me see if I can get any closer. Yeah, I'm really happy with that. It looks like a peacock feather, of course, and sort of I don't know how to describe it, but it's going to go really nice with hoity-toity when it's done, I think. And it's on 40 count. And since I've been stitching it in hand, you know, it's getting a lot easier. You know, this is the first time that I've tried to stitch 40 count in hand. And sometimes I do have to use magnifying glasses. Where did I put them? Oh, I don't have them right here. They're just, I was just going to show you the ones that I have, but it goes really quick stitching in hand. That's all I have to say. Now, an update on this one. This is Maddie. This is our Rottweiler. I've been doing a portrait of her. I started it I technically started it before I finished the Greyhound. But since I've finished the Greyhound this year, I had said that I wanted to do a portrait of a Rottweiler for our dog, Maddie. And unfortunately, Maddie has been having some health issues. You know, and we do have to take her to a specialist soon to at least diagnose what's going on with her, but so she's been on my mind, and I've been working on it a little bit. So I wanted to show you the update on Maddie the Rottweiler. This is a kit from Panna, which is a Russian company, and I am doing it on 36 count linen from Under the Sea Fabrics. And it's called Whimsical Winter. Now, I showed them in a previous video this year, but I'm doing it on blue fabric to match the blue background of some needle points that my grandmother did. And so far, I'm really happy with how this one's coming out. The most work is going to be in the mouth and the teeth and the tongue and all those things, you know. And then there's a collar, which I haven't decided what to do. I think I will stitch it as is. It's red, you know, but I might try to change up the colors, maybe. Maddie has a purple or pink harness, so. But the red looks nice, too. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. That's why I'm saving it for last, so I can decide later. Okay. And, well, you know, my birthday is in November and it's coming up. I'll be 37 this year. And last year I had started for my birthday celebration, sort of like a start event. You know, I just started a bunch of stuff from stash, just either stuff I had or patterns from Etsy. And I'm bringing them back out again to work on them some more. So I wanted to show you, I don't even think I've ever showed them in an actual Flosstube update. You know, I was waiting till I had more progress. But this one is the one I started for my birthday last year. And I'll show a picture of it. It's this cute little sloth hanging off a coffee cup. And it's got a lot of blends in it. It's one of those Russian patterns, and the back stitch is going to be a bear, right? So, but this is what I've got so far. I haven't even, I'm worried about it not looking good, because this is probably why I haven't showed it yet, because the coffee cup looks really good, but the sloth is still just unfinished and doesn't look, I mean, he's, I haven't even done his eyes yet, so. But this is on dark vanilla, 32 count dark vanilla from Handdyed Happiness, and that is going to be really, really cute when it's done. I don't know if I'm going to finish it right now, but I enjoy it. That's just the way I feel in the winter and in the fall, you know, cozying up to a cup of coffee, and yeah. So I'm planning to work on this some, but like I said, there's like blends, like where I had gotten to in the point in the pattern, every single color I need to stitch is like a blend. So it was off-putting me, but another one I've been working on, this is one I started last year, is a skyline of Atlanta. I'll put a picture of that one up. It's by Awesome Pattern Studio. And let's see, this is where I'm at. I've been sort of identifying the buildings. When I first got it, I wasn't sure which building was which. Okay, stop focusing on my face. Here. This is on 22 count hardanger. And I like the colorful buildings. The tallest building in Atlanta is the Bank of America Plaza, which that is obviously supposed to be. And this, I think it's the SunTrust building. And this one over here is supposed to be the Georgia Pacific Tower. And this one, it's like two buildings put together. I'm pretty sure is 191 Peachtree Street. Is it Peachtree Tower? Or I can't remember. You know, it's hard to keep track, especially with the artistic license and the pattern, basically. I don't know. And some of them just weren't, I don't know where the perspective was from that pattern, you know, in the city, but some of them aren't to scale, is what I'm saying. But it's a cute pattern, and it makes me think of Georgia, and yeah, I started for my birthday last year, and I'm doing that with one strand of the CXC floss, and same with the sloth pattern that I keep calling moth. It's with CXC floss too. So those were two fun quick stitches. So let's see where we're at. The last one I wanted to show you guys is just a quick update on Southern Land by Al Forrest Embroidery. I've brought this right around to 50% now, I think. I have to go back. It may be over 50%. I have to check. Everything I'm working on is in Pattern Keeper. So, oh man, this is going to be gorgeous. Let me show you. I didn't get a chance to iron it, like I said, so there's a big crease in it. I'm pretty sure I am over 50%. I finished this motif in the middle, under the middle, and I've been working on this this flower motifs on this side. Like I said, this is in, I'm stitching this with Pattern Keeper, which is helping immensely. And again, it is an Owl Forest embroidery pattern, which is a Russian company, of course. But for some reason, it just reminds me of something patriotic, just the reds and the blues on the beige background. It's on 36 count light mocha from Zweigart. And yeah, that's going to be, I just love that one. I'd like to finish it next year. I'm already sort of looking ahead to my plans for next year. Of course, I'm trying to do his eyes on the sparrow. I've got to frog. I think I've pretty much decided at this point I'm going to frog the tree and proceed from there. But I have to order some more thread to do it. So, and I'm not in the mind space to do that. I just wanted to share, you know, I've told you that I am doing diamond painting now, and I decided to participate in an event called Diamond Painting Advent, basically. The hashtag is DP Advent 2020. And what you do is you section off your canvas. You pick a project, you section off your canvas, and then you, like an advent calendar, basically, and you count down the days, you complete the days to count down to Christmas. And I've been working on Festive Fireplace from Diamond Art Club, which is taking up a lot of my time. You know, it takes me almost all day to complete the assigned square in order to have, you know, I'm going to complete it hopefully by Christmas Eve. So I'm just going to put a couple of pictures or a segment in there real quick to show you guys what I've been doing. But it's kind of fun, and, you know, just for the holidays, getting me, you know, in a positive spirit after, you know, the election and, you know, everything else that's going on. Like, of course, the pandemic is still very serious in the United States. So we don't plan to really go anywhere for Thanksgiving, you know. But having another craft on the side to participate in, especially over the holidays, is kind of keeping me, you know, pretty positive, although it's back and forth. I don't know. It's kind of difficult to explain what goes on in my head near the end of the year. Like I said, it's my birthday, you know, and then the holidays, and we miss people that had, you know, that we don't get to see, you know, for whatever reason. And yeah, it's going to be different this year. But I'll be back in a couple of weeks, and I'll talk a little bit, hopefully, about, you know, I want to have some finishes before the end of the year, you know, but I'm trying not to stress out about it too much. So anyway, I'm glad you guys watched, and I can't remember if there was anything else I wanted to tell you, but it was the video actually went by quicker than I thought. I thought I was going to spend more time showing you my projects. So anyway, it was nice to have a little chat with you, and I'll talk to you guys later, and happy stitching.